It's been a pretty crazy season so far in 2014. Tonight you guys clinched the South Division Championship, and it wasn't a day without craziness. You find out the pitcher who was supposed to go tonight, John Link, gets picked up. You have to throw your pitching coach because you have to scramble to find somebody, and he goes out and gets a win.
We really didn't have a whole lot of options. You get a phone call at 3:30 from the Marlins, and they're taking your starting pitcher for the night, who is typically your ace at that. So it was crazy. It was a whirlwind there for a bit. We're trying to figure out, as you saw, what we're going to do for tonight, and being short in the bullpen didn't help. So Luke was ready to step up and activate himself and try to get us going, and the big bear was tremendous. I tell you, I can't say enough about him and what he did for us tonight and to get the win. He went out there and competed. Honestly, I had a great feeling about it. I really did. With the circumstances, like you said, that we've been dealt with a lot of times this year, nothing seems to faze us. We just bounce back whatever's thrown at us.
Before the game, there was a lot of talk about try and get us three innings, keep us in the ball game. He said, I'm going to go fastball, changeup mostly, not try and do too much. But you could tell the juices started to get flowing a little bit, and he kept wanting to go back out there more and more.
Yeah, and as we went along, he really wasn't fazed. It helped to put the five spot up in the second to get going offensively, give him some runs, where we did have a little cushion. So as long as he could go, as long as we were staying in the ballgame, I was going to let him go. And the third finished, and he wanted to go back out for the fourth. And then I thought we were pushing our buttons maybe going in the fifth, but I didn't want anything more but to get him a win. Especially, he deserved it. You know, being able to step up to the plate and give us an outing that we had no idea who it was going to be, and for it to be him, I really appreciate it. Can't thank him enough. And it's just like I said, it's been a lot of fun this year, and what a way for him to get the win on the night that we clinched the South Division.
I want to talk to you about the offensive side of things as well. Bell Nieves, since he's come back to Wichita, has 8 straight hits now. He's only been held hitless in 3 at-bats, and then Brent Cleveland since the All-Star break, 30 RBI now in 23 games.
A lot of fun to watch. It's a pretty potent lineup. We're not fazed, like I said, by a whole lot of things. We just typically bounce back. It is what it is. It's standard business, as I always say around here. We expect to win when we go to the yard every single day, and that's what we try to instill in these guys every single day that we show up at the yard. So, like I continue to say, it's just been a fun year, and Cleve's on fire right now, and to have Abby be able to add him back, to lose a Jake Kahalio, it's going to be tough to deal with. But you add a guy like Abby in his position, and he's going to do nothing but help us, not only offensively, but defensively out at second. And like I said, if you're going to pick a guy to replace Jake, who is irreplaceable for that matter, to get a guy like Abby is a tremendous help, and we're very fortunate that Grand Prairie was willing to work with us on that.
Before we let you go, you've won a North Division Championship, a Central Division Championship, or two, or three, and now a South Division Championship. They never get old, do they?
It doesn't, Bob. It doesn't. It really doesn't. I think it just goes to show the hard work that we put in and the dedication of all of our guys and the teams that we put together. We work hard as a staff, as you know, and it all starts with us, our staff. I can't do what I do without Jose, Luke, and Foltzy, and I can't thank them enough for the hours and time that they put into this as well as I do. Our whole front office staff, this is a team thing. It's not about me. It's not about one individual. It's about all of us, not only us players and coaches, but the front office, the owners. It all starts at the top, and it's been a fun run, and I hope we can continue to do so for a while now.
First of all, congratulations on your 4th straight division championship, the first time in the South. Wichita Wingnuts are the first team to win a championship in the North, Central, and South Division. What does that mean to you?
Being a part of all of them, it means a lot to me. We've got a great team, and these guys deserve this. They've grinded it out all year, and it's good to see us finally get into a position where we're in the playoffs.
I know when you woke up this morning, you weren't planning on starting the game today. It was kind of a late decision. You found out about 3 hours before the game. Things worked out okay, didn't they?
Seemed to, yeah. I just tried to do what I tell our guys to do, is trust your defense and go out and get ahead and be aggressive and make them earn what they get.
I know before the game there was a lot of talk about trying to get 3 innings. You weren't going to throw too many breaking balls, stick with the fastball, changeup. Once you get the juices going a little bit, though, is it hard not to be more competitive and want to keep going out inning after inning?
Yeah, but you got to realize where you're at, too. And that's I haven't pitched in essentially 10 years. And so I knew I had to pace myself to be able to give us what we needed to get to our bullpen and give them a chance to go ahead and finish the game out. And it worked out. Our defense did a great job behind us. Guys go out and put up a 5 spot in the second. That makes it pretty easy to go out and pitch to contact.
This is your first win in 11 years. There's no thoughts of coming back full time, is there?
No, absolutely not. I'm done. I'm good. I'm retired. I'm glad I could help the guys out tonight. I'm glad I could help our team out tonight, put us in a position to win the ball game. And if that's the last game I pitch, I'm all right.
Appreciate the time, Luke. Anybody wants to say hi to you back home?
My son Beckett, my wife Shauna, my mom and dad, all my family, all my friends that had an opportunity to watch the game tonight. Appreciate you guys tuning in.